بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. نحييكم اليوم في الحلقة الرابعة من الدروس الجميلة جدا اللي بيقدمها لنا الشيخ بابكر أحمد بابكر في القرآن الكريم وقصص من السنة النبوية. بس للناس اللي انضموا لنا أو بدوا يشاهدونا من اليوم، أنا عايز أعمل لكم تذكرة سريعة. كل الحلقات دي موجودة في اليوتيوب، مما الحلقة الأولى اللي بديناها اللي هي كانت Don't judge a book by its cover زي ما شايفينها على الشمال هنا تحت، والحلقة الثانية كانت إنه الناس the people they need help from each other، وthe third episode which was yesterday كانت عن the importance of fulfilling your promises. فكل ال episodes once الشيخ finish once we finish the episode we will upload it to the YouTube and they will be in a series as you can see it 1, 2, 3. والليلة today إن شاء الله الشيخ will talk to us about the importance of what we do or what exactly he will recommend and advise us on what to do during this pandemic, this period now we are going through. And this was a direct request from one of the parents yesterday. So inshallah, I will introduce a sheikh shortly. Please share the link with all the people you know. It's quite clear, it's sudanknowledge.org in the Facebook. I will introduce a sheikh. فلكن let me have your questions while we are talking. So now I'm just going to hide this one so I can get a sheikh on board. طيب شيخ السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام سيدي دكتور علام، كيف حالك؟ ان شاء
الله طيب. حييك والناس دي كلهم they are very grateful وthey are يدعو لك بالخير و...
امين.
انا عشان نستفيد من وقتك كله اتفضل ابدا، وبرضه فكره لو تدي الناس في البدايه توريهم بكره وبعد بكره ويوم الجمعه زي ما حضرتك تكرمت بانه حنعمل شنو فيما يتعلق برمضان.
جدا
اتفضل يا شيخ. عليكم السلام.
اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وآله أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ربي أودعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. My dear brothers and sisters in Iman and all my children, my sons and my daughters who are sitting and watching, I am so grateful that you are listening, because there is nothing better than learning and teaching. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ وَعَلَّمْ. The best of you is the one who learns and teaches others. But وَخَيْرُهُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. But the best of them, the best of the learners and the teachers are those who will learn the Quran and teaches the Quran. And I wish and I hope this will be in the balance of our books in the day of judgment for all of us, inshallah. As Dr. Alam says, today's subject, inshallah, I'll speak about in a minute, but for tomorrow and the day after tomorrow and Friday, I'm going to, inshallah, speak about preparation for Ramadan. As you know, we are living in the West, people always think Ramadan is fasting and fasting is Ramadan. So therefore, I want to clarify for our children and for many who are not maybe perhaps Muslim listening, what is Ramadan? So tomorrow our subject will be what is Ramadan, to talk about the significance of the month of Ramadan. And then the day after tomorrow, inshallah, biiznillahi ta'ala, we will be talking about what is fasting. Okay? And on Friday, we'll talk about preparation for fasting, how to prepare ourselves so that we can fast in the month of Ramadan. May Allah make it easy for us and bless the remainder of this month of Sha'ban for us and allow us to live during the month of Ramadan. Today's subject has come from one of the parents who asked me to relate to all those who are listening, especially the children, how can they cope while they are imprisoned within the walls of their homes? And it is hard and it is difficult. So what to do in the case of a pandemic? What shall we do? I am going to relate this to you from the Quran, from two verses. Those two verses are in Surah Ali Imran, Surah number 3. And subhanAllah, it fits exactly the condition we are in. When Islam came at the beginning, many of the people who embraced Islam were very poor, very weak, those who are shunned, and those who are really, really in the lowest standing in the society. So the powerful people, the rich people, used to frighten them. So Allah said in the Quran, this is verses 173, 174 سورة نمبر 3 سورة آل عمران. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم. Those whom people came to them and said to them, be fearful, for there are those who want your destruction. فاخشوهم, be frightened of them. Once this has been said to them, Allah said, فزادهم إيمانا. These words did not really put fear in their heart or made them feel worried or anguished. They became more stronger in their iman. وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. They said, our savior is Allah and he is sufficient. And he is the best in supporting and helping us. Because they said حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل, Allah said, فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله. Their life turned with a lot of bounties from Allah. وفضل. And Allah increased them in every favor that he has already given to them. لم يمسسهم سوء. No harm ever came their way. واتبعوا رضوان الله. And they followed the path of Allah. والله ذو فضل عظيم. And Allah is the possessor of all the extras he gives to those whom he loves. Now, when I was reading this, I remembered, subhanAllah, a wasiya. Wasiya literally meaning a reminder, an advice given by the Prophet to some companions. One of his most favorite companions, he used to advise, إِذَا بَذَرَ الْقِفَارِ. But also he used to advise others like Ali ibn Abi Talib. One day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ya Ali, أَمَانٌ لِأُمَّتِي من الهم. Oh Ali, a net of safety for my ummah, for my people, from depression. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. No power, no will can be initiated from oneself only by the support and the help of Allah. لا ملجأ ولا منجأ من الله إلا إليه. There is no escape and there is no place of safety only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is beautiful because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran to those who believe in him at the time of difficulty, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Do escape to Allah. Now, what we are going through, this pandemic, happened many, many times before. Different scales from the time before the Prophet ﷺ. But in his time, he taught us clearly that when you are in a condition of destroying the people, you must make yourself a server to serve others and help them, rather than become somebody who only becomes selfish, self-centered, looking after yourself. Literally meaning, when a pandemic is taking place and it is about to destroy the people, if you are in a place where this pandemic is taking place, stay put. Don't leave it. And if you are traveling to a place and you are almost there and you heard that place is being inflicted, then you must return back. And this is really paramount. And you should never be frightened or worried. I know we will be frightened. And fear is a part of our test. وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ, Allah said in the Quran, and we will surely test you by some fear. It will come. So we will have anxiety. We will have fear. We will have worries. And we will have too many things going within. If we don't look after ourselves, then we'll become lazy. Then we'll become helpless, unable to do for ourselves. Then sadness will enter into our hearts. And for sure, if we don't care about ourselves properly, according to the teaching of Allah Almighty, depression will be our lot. We will be depressed. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-ham. Oh Allah, I seek refuge in you from depression. It's not a very good thing to have. My worry is, people are in two ways. Shall they go out and live their life normally? Or shall they stay put in their homes, knowing that it's like a prison? Perhaps the prison is better, because you are asked to go out and play games and have fun and do whatever you want to do, but we are sitting sometime in little box flats. Some people are living in bed seats or a hotel room. It's too hard. I know that. May Allah remove this difficulty. But yet, there are things that this time we must do. And they come of two sides. One side, the physical way of living the life while we are secluded. And the other part is the spiritual side, which links to the hadith I recited of the advice of Sayyidina Rasulullah Sallam to Ali ibn Abi Talib and the verse of the Quran, which Allah taught us when people are in that kind of condition. If they only can say Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel, and then their will and their power link it to Allah, then everything will be all right. What shall we do when we are in this condition? The first important thing is to obey those who are responsible for us. Allah said in the Quran, وَأَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ and do obey Allah, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ and do obey the messenger, وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ and those who are responsible for you. Allah and His messenger are known. From the teaching, we know what they want us to do and what they ask us to refrain from. However, who are ulil amr? Who are the people responsible for us? It begins with your parents, your elders, your teachers, the police people who are responsible for security in the street, your boss at work, and anybody who's leading you, and the government that runs the affairs in the land you live. Our government in England or Britain, the UK, has said already we should stay at home. We should only go out for necessity. This becomes paramount. If we really have faith, then we must obey this. For me, Britain is my home. Rasulullah says, حُبُّ الْوَطَن مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ Loving where you live is a part of your faith. If I love this country, where I earn my living, where I have my roof over my head, and where my children are secured and looked after, then I must listen and stay at home. We must also follow the guidelines that are given by the government and those who are responsible for finding solution for the pandemic. Among the health people, the Ministry of Health, and anybody who is in that field. Too many people are going into the internet and listening to people writing things. Amazing. Yesterday I heard something nonsensical. People are going out and burning out the G5 poles because they think it brings this disease to their area. In some cases, like in India, I heard people are fighting the health people when they are coming to check them because they think they are bringing with them the disease. All this has no place. There is nothing more important than having true knowledge. Allah said in the Quran, if anybody bring you any news and you don't know who the person is, you need to check it first before you pass it through. Unfortunately today, through social media, we receive something, we just send it. Please be careful. Perhaps you might damage the life of others. And in the day of judgment, you will be responsible before Allah and you'll be questioned about it. So only listen to information that comes from legitimate people who will give you the right information. This is to do with your parents at home, to do with your teachers in the schools, to do with your local authority, those who are responsible for your area, and your government, or the people of knowledge, among the medical staff in this case, and the people of religion standing in the community. And we should remember, if we are ill, stay put. Don't leave the place where you are ill, because you might take the disease with you. And if we are going to a place and we know that place have got somebody who's ill, we should not get there. Go back. And we should make our 24 hours proper. because otherwise we are going to get lazy and we are going to get tired and we are going to get sad. That might lead us to depression. So what should we do from the morning to the evening? First of all, when you wake up in the morning, you must make sure you pray your salah. And let me remind you, Allah said in the Quran, O you who believe, remember me a lot and glorify me before sunrise and before sunset. Nobody should be sleeping when sun is rising. We should wake up. That's a very good time to remember Allah. You can pray your subuh prayer, fajr prayer, at the last 20 minutes, 15 minutes. Doesn't matter. As long as you are awake before sunrise. What you do then? You do the thing that will keep you good all the day. And thereafter, you can go back to bed if you feel it is too early and rest. And I remind everybody, make sure you pray your other prayers in their time. Make sure you take some time to read Quran. Make some time to sit with your family and talk. Some time to play some game. Some time to exercise. And sometimes to sit alone and think and ponder. Allah said in the Quran, and do reflect and ponder upon the creation of the heaven and the earth. And the final thing, we must hold on to salah and dua. And the thing that I'm going to leave you with is this. In the hadith, the advice of Sayyidina Rasulullah, Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib, we should read this. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا ملجأ ولا منجأ إلا إليه. This we should read every day. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا ملجأ ولا منجأ من الله إلا إليه. If we read this at least 3 times in the morning, 3 times in the evening, it will save us. Also, بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم. 3 times. If every day we do this, Allah will save us. And حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. I'm gonna finish with this little story, 1 minute perhaps. And this happened to me personally. When I was young, I was brought up among a lot of elders. And I used to go to the masjid for all the prayers between Maghrib and Isha every day. It was the best thing. We sit and listen to stories from the Sheikh who used to teach us Quran. And one of the things he taught us, it's always to depend upon Allah. To know that you have got the will to do things for yourself. But remember, you are doing it because Allah has created you. So you will do it in the right way through the advice you received from his Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and your teachers and your parents. Never go astray. Always keep in the right path. And they taught us to always, when you find yourself in a position of fear or worries or anguish, when I came to England and I was an adult, I was going from one place to another in a city in Britain where there was a lot of fight between the English and the foreigners who were in that place. I didn't know, and I was passing in the street. And it was late afternoon, and suddenly, in the middle of the road, there was a big fight. The people who were fighting from the native, they were called the skinheads. They didn't want the foreigners to be here. And the others are the foreigners who were living and working. And I had never seen something like this in my life. And they were fighting and kicking and blood all over the place. So I took myself to the side of the wall and I remembered what my teachers and my elders taught me. And I put my head down, I walked, and I was just repeating, Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakeel. Suddenly I could hear this voice shouting, you, you. I raised my head to look. There are too many people, tens of them fighting. And I realized, subhanAllah, the police closed the 2 sides of the road and they were pulling people, throwing them in the vans. And I didn't say nothing. And suddenly this officer said to me, you? I said, I? He said, yes, come here. What are you doing here? I said to him, look, I'm just a student living in a place. I'm going to visit some friends and I'm just returning back home now. He says, you shouldn't be here. Come, come. He called a car, take this guy to his home. They put me in the car, they delivered me home. They don't know who I am. What am I doing there? Where I came from? Where am I going? But yet, because I put my trust in Allah, Allah took away the fear from my heart not to be in a position like this. For that, I trust in Allah fully. If people turn to him, they will always find him, inshallah, sufficient. May Allah bless me and bless you and give us tawfiq to hold tight unto the book of Allah and the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullah khairan.
طيب يا شيخ شكرا لك جزيلا جزاك الله كله خير.
آمين.
من الأسئلة الأولى الجاد عشان نمتلك الأسئلة كثيرة نكسب الزمن، الأجر بتاع الأطفال لأنه يساعدوا والدينهم عشان الرسالة دي صل للأطفال. نعم. أجرهم شنو في مساعدة الوالدين؟ كثير مرات يقول لك أنا اللي ساعد لي ده ليه أعمل ده في البيت؟
أنا لما الله أكبر منهم ده سؤال مهم جدا جدا يا دكتور. سبحان الله، الإنسان اللي بيساعد ربنا بيساعده. احنا ذكرنا قلنا الناس بالناس ومن يعين يعن. People are always in need of one another. But only those who support others, helps others, they will be helped. So I am as an individual, whether I'm a child or an adult. If I help some other people, whether I know them or not, for sure, others will help me. I'm going to give you an example. For example, if I'm living in an area and in front of my road where I am, or in front of my home in the road where I live, I see somebody who is in need of help to carry something or to cross the road. If I go and help them and support them, if one day I'm in a condition whereby I need help, even if there is nobody there to come and help me, Allah will provide the help from a place where I will never even think it will come. And therefore, for children who are sitting at home, they should remember their parents are responsible for them to be looked after, then cared for, and educated. Every support they require, whether it is feeding, clothing, cleaning themselves, taking them to school, bringing them back, who is doing this job? It's their parents, because they are responsible for them. And therefore, if those children want to grow up and to find the help from their own children, inshallah, in the future, and from Allah in any condition they find themselves in, they must support their parents. Allah said in the Quran, وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And your parents have a right over you that you should always be kind and good to them, inshallah.
طيب يا شيخ، في سؤال يتسأل أمس بكم حتى هو في المسجد بعد أمس، لكن لأنه السيستم أبخل ينجي أمس. في سؤال بتسأل، لأنه حتى لو حصل حلقات دي حاولنا نعمل الساعة 2 عشان أطفال. الأطفال اللي أمات دي بسهروا شديد، يعني أنا حصل قصتي في عدد من الآباء بيقولوا نفس الحاجة والأمهات.
نعم.
يعني بيقعدوا لحد واحدة صباحا واثنين، وبعدين طبعا الظروف صعبة جدا، وحتى دارين نشوف دكتورة ميادة يوم تتكلم معنا في الظروف النفسية للأطفال في القفلة دي.
نعم.
فأنت هل عندك أي نصايح إنه كيف نخلي الأطفال دي ما يسهروا كثير؟
جدا والله. أهم شيء مولانا، it is so important to realize that we need to govern our time. If a child goes to sleep at 1 o'clock, where in the normal days of the school, he goes to bed 8:30, 9:00, 10:00 maximum for the older children, it is difficult for them to come back to this routine whereby they can sleep earlier on. Okay? And therefore, I will say, just to have a proper program of living life, there should be a time whereby we go to bed. And specifically now in Britain, for us, because the time of the summer is starting, Fajr is coming earlier and earlier. If a child is asleep at 1 o'clock in the morning or 2 o'clock in the morning, how do they expect themselves to wake up before sunrise? Today's sunrise was 6 or 5, in fact, no. 6:23 in the morning. This is sunrise. So that means a person must wake up before 6:23 to make sure that they pray their salah. And to remember Allah. And I tell you another thing. Parents need to lead their children in this. If the children see their parents going to bed late, the children are going to go late. When I used to be teaching in English schools, there was a very wonderful English boy. Every morning he used to come to me. I used to ask him, James, how are you? He said, oh, miserable. Why are you miserable, James? Oh, last night my mother was watching a film. When I want to sit with her, she said, oh, not for you. You have to go to bed because you have to go to school. So I felt it is my duty to tell that mother. Her son loves her very much, but because of only this thing, the child is not fitting with her in the same thing. So when I explained to her, and she began to make sure that he goes to bed first, and then after he goes to bed, then she can sit and do what she wants, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, the child has changed 180 degrees. So my advice to the parents, lead your children to govern their time properly and eat together. If you can pray together, pray together. If you can sit and read Quran together, read together. And any discussion you have together will help, inshallah, the family to carry through, بإذن الله تعالى.
طيب يا شيخ، في سؤال هنا من فاطمة، ما أعرف هل بتقدر الوقت بكفي، بتقول لك تفسير الآية 60 من سورة الإسراء.
نعم.
هل دي نخليها لي وقت تاني ولا تقدر تجاب على الآن؟
والله ممكن، لكن لو عشان ما ناخذ الايه ده وقت، خلينا انا بكره اذا جيت
قلت لك حساباتك
خليك ايوه اما ارد على السؤال الاول.
هنا برضو قبل ما اريد في سؤال برضو جانا امبارح في نجلاء محمد قالت لك يا شيخ بعد اذنك انا بحاول بس اعرض لك على رسائل الناس واللي بيجوا فيك خير دير عشان تكون متابعون بعد اذنك عندي بنتي عمرها 8 نخليها بكره ولا في الايام الجايه نديها فرصه تقرا لك قران قالت لك
ما في اي مانع. هنعمل اليوم في رمضان من رمضان يبدا كل يوم حيكون عندنا حلقه هنعمل يوم خصيصا للقران اوكي هنتكلم فيه. واليوم اللي بعده طوالي هندي فرصه للاطفال يجوا يقروا لي قران ونتكلم معهم ان شاء الله.
ممتاز جدا كويس انه الناس بدات تنجيش بعض. طيب يا شيخ امبارح في سؤال بالمساء حصل لانه تكون انت متابع رئيس الوزراء امس الصباح دخلوا المستشفى لانه الحراره لسه يعني هو لو 9 يوم بس درجه الحراره شويه يعني قالوا القحه شويه قلت لكن درجه الحراره ما نزلت.
نعم
قاموا ودوه المستشفى امبارح في سان توماس وبالمساء يطلع الخبر بريكنج نيوز قالوا انه حالته يعني تحذيرا حيستعد وحيدخلوه في الانتنسيف كير. فاحنا قمنا انا وكثيرين يعني عملنا في الفيسبوك قلنا يا اخي ادعو لي وبانه ربنا يعجل بالشفاء وادعو له بالشفاء ولا ويتعافى. ففي ناس كثيره طوال بلد تجاوب وتدعم طبعا لحظة الشعب كله بيدعي له. فقام أمس جات مسجد بالليل بتقول إنه اللسان ما مسلم ما مفروض ندعي له وحرام وحلال. فرأيك شنو بالنسبة للغير مسلم زي ما في حالتنا دي ده ما مسلم هل يجوز إنه نحن المسلمين ندعي له ولا ما يجوز؟
يا مولانا
والأساس في الكلام ده شنو؟
يا سيدنا أنا I will give this message to everybody who is listening.
ممتاز.
Please listen to me.
أيوة.
We don't listen to people telling us what to do. We only take our teaching from the Quran. I'm from the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ممتاز.
We are the people of the straight path. نحن أهل الصراط المستقيم. ماذا تعلمنا من النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ Our Prophet peace be upon him once upon a time was sitting with his companions and a janaza was carried by him by people passing through him and the companions and he immediately got up. They said يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
عليه الصلاة
والسلام. جنازة أفنان مسلم. He said it's a روح. But ya Rasulullah, he's not a believer. He said, no, it's a spirit. But he did not believe in you or the message. He said, I did not have the chance to deliver the message to him.
Yes,
I will say to everybody who's saying this, did you go to the Prime Minister of England and sat with him and deliver the message of Islam to him and he refused to become a Muslim? Number one. Number two, didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us in the Quran that there are those who believe and there are those who are Muslims? And there are those who don't believe. Those who are believers and not Muslim, they're Ahlul Kitab. Allah said, their food is halal for us. Our food is halal for them. We are allowed to marry their women, and there is a reason for that, and to have children from them. And they can live as Christian or Jews if they like to do so, as long as the children are brought as Muslims. Today, unfortunately, we want to marry their women, but we don't want. And the most saddest thing, you can't say salam to them. Astaghfirullah, I married a Christian woman. When I have children from her, Assalamu alaikum Ahmed, Assalamu alaikum Fatima, good morning Elizabeth. Why? Because she's not a Muslim. That doesn't make sense. Allah said in the Quran, فَإِذَا حُيُّتُمْ بِتَحِيَّةٍ فَحَيُّ بِأَحْسَنَ مِنْهَا أَوْ رُدُّهَا. If you are greeted by any greeting, greet by a better greeting. If you are stingy, if you are mean, أنت بخيل, قول لك نفس الكلام. تخيل أنت في الجامعة يا دكتور. جاك دكتور ماريسون. قال لك, oh, Professor Allah, Assalamu alaikum. تقول له, oh, hello, I can't repeat the same thing because you're not a Muslim. Doesn't make sense. And I give you the final thing. And this should convince everybody. Allah said in the Quran, the Christians whom Allah has taught them through Jesus to worship the one and to follow the teaching of Musa alayhi salam in the Torah. Although they took Jesus as to be son of God. His mother is the mother of God. And sometimes they talk of him as God. In the day of judgment, Allah will ask Sayyidina Isa, did you and your mother, أَأَنْتَ وَأُمَّكَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِ إِلَهِينِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ? Did you and your mother said to the people, to take you as God beside me? Look at Isa. He didn't say, oh Allah, they went astray, they were kuffar, throw them in the hell. No, 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 no. Look at the teaching of the Prophet, صلى الله عليه وسلم. Sayyidina Isa said to Allah, if I said to them, you will be aware of it. However, if you forgive them, you are the most forgiving.
Yes, Allah.
إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك. If you are going to punish them, they are your servant. وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. However, if you forgive them, you are the most forgiving, most merciful. Look at this gentleman, this beautiful human being. The أخلاق النبوية يا مولانا.
صحيح.
And I will tell you one thing. Why these people who say these things, when these kuffar in their mind see a dilemma, a problem, a calamity in our countries, and they rush, who helped the Palestinian parents? Who helped the people who were suffering in the drought in 86 in Sudan and Ethiopia, if it's not for the English? The singers of Western Britain or the Western world, they sang and they raised millions and they fed our people. Okay? And now they are doing it. Where are we when these things are happening? Do you understand? We are putting our feet on the table and saying, oh, if they are good believers, Allah will not punish them. Are we the best believers? We cannot judge ourselves. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تُزَكُّوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمْ بِمَنَ اتَّقَى. Do not judge yourself to be
better. يا شيخ ذاته في نفس المستشفى اللي هو راقد فيه امبارح وما زال. امبارح ناس البي بي سي جايبين لقاء مع واحد برضه رجل كبير من اسمه يعني شكله باكستاني بالعربي اسمه يعني اسمه بس مسلمين. فنفس المستشفى دي بيتعالجوا فيها المسلمين وبنفس يقول طيب يا شيخ هسه في سؤال جاي هنا مع انه يعني بسخر مع انه الزمن والله اللي مشى علينا لكن نستفيد من الفرصه دي لانه السؤال ده بقول لك يا سلام عليك يا ريت لو تذكروا الاخوان بهذا حتى التهنئه بالكريسماس بيحرموها فممكن نربط هو التهنئه الكريسماس دي رايك فيها شنو طالما تكلمنا هسه عن انه ندعو لهم انه ربنا يعني يشفيهم ويرفعهم فما الكريسماس كيف هل وضعه بيختلف
يا شيخنا حاجة. يا شيخنا ما معنى هابي كريسماس كريسماس كريسماس
ايوه
اذا سيلبريشن اوف ذا بيرث داي اوف سيدنا عيسى هل يا ترى نحرم نحن we forbid for those people to celebrate their own religion or their own occasion احنا في بريطانيا
معلش يا جماعه نحن فقدنا الشيخ فجاه ما عارف السبب شنو فننتظر شويه بس ان شاء الله يكون ما عارف الحصل عندي شنو في طبعا الشيخ في مكان ثاني فممكن في الأثناء دي ما عارف الحصل شنو أنا لأنه فجأة فقدنا الشيخ في فممكن لحد ما الشيخ يرجع لنا أذكركم إنه الحلقات دي نحن لنا فترة بنعمل فيها عملت الحلقة الأولى كانت عن Don't judge a book by its cover والحلقة دي موجودة في اليوتيوب الشيخ رجع لنا هاي واصل يا شيخ معلش فقدناك قبل شويه
ايوه نعم معلش
واصل
يا فانا قصدي شنو قصدي انه نحن سبحان الله في عايشين في زمن لا بد لنا ان نعلم بان الله سبحانه وتعالى حيث ان يوم القيامه هل وصلنا الرساله المحمديه متمسكين بها دي للناس ولا ما هنوصلها للناس فهمت علي
صحيح
الكلام ده حيحصل كيف بمعاملاتنا نحن للناس إذا عملنا الناس بالإحسان إذا عملناهم بالخير إذا كلمناهم بالطريقة الجميلة يحصل خير الكريسماس يا مولانا ما هو إلا عبارة عن احتفال هم بيحتفل تخيل إحنا في عيد رمضان جاي الآن والعيد جاي لو قاموا الناس منعونا أنه نحتفل ولا نجتمع ولا نصوم لا سبحان الله ربنا سبحانه وتعالى قال لا إكراها في الدين لكم دينكم ولي دين دي كلها آيات في القرآن فلذلك إحنا منهني الإنسان بما هو في دينه هل الاحتفال بالعيد الميلاد غلط النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يصوم الاثنين هي صلى الله عليه وسلم used to fast every Monday they asked him لما تصوم الاثنين يا رسول الله why do you fast on Mondays قال يوم ولدت فيه هذا يوم ولد هذا اليوم الذي ولدت فيه this is the day I was born فما يجوز لا بد أن نعمل الناس بالإحسان يا مولانا
صح وسع هذا عبد الرحمن دي مسجات من عبد الرحمن عبد الرحيم قال لك الآن المسلمون ينتظرون الخواجات اختروا علاج للكورونا والناس في المساجد بتدعو عليهم فأسا احنا لقينا العلاج ده يجي من عندهم
يا مولانا believe me listen to me carefully there is no reason to make دعاء against anybody قالوا البرمي حجر لو رموا عليه حجرين ما يسأل okay whoever throws one pebble if he get two back should not question it because you have started it. And therefore, we need to think carefully. We shouldn't make dua against people. I remember once, okay, after 11 September, they brought the Sheikh of the Haram in Mecca, in BBC, live, I was watching it. And they said to him, do you make dua against the non-Muslims? He said, of course not. Are you sure you don't do this? He said, no, we don't. And the man put a tape for him, in front of him. And the same Sheikh was making a dua, اللهم حطم أهل الغرب, اللهم حطم النصارى, اللهم حطم اليهود. His faith became red. وجهه أحمر يا مولانا. فأنا خجلت. إذا كان هذا إمامنا في الحرم المكي يقول يكذب, هو كان بيدعو هنا أثبت له, فهنا حيفكر فينا أننا ما عندنا غيمة لديننا. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان صادقا أمينا في قوله لا يكذب عليه الصلاة والسلام. فلا بد لنا أن نفكر, لا ندعو على الناس. أنا كنت والله يا مولانا في السودان في وزارة الشؤون الدينية والأوقاف, كان عنده ورشة عمل, فقدم الورشة رجل سبحان الله كان بيتكلم فيها كلام سيء عن الغرب. فقلت سألت سؤال, قلت له يا مولانا هل زرت الغرب؟ قال لي لا. زرت فرنسا, بريطانيا, لندن؟ لا. قلت له كيف بتقول الكلام ده يا مولانا؟ هل تعلم أنه بريطانيا فيها أكثر من 4 مليون مسلم؟ هل فيها أكثر من 2000 مسجد؟ مجلس اللوردات فيه صلاة جمعة, أنا أصلي الجمعة في الشهر. أوكي, The Bank of England فيه جمعة وفيه مسجد, كل سجن فيه مسجد وعندهم إمامين, واحد للتربية واحد للتعليم والصلاة, وكل مكان يا شيخ جامعات. فقال لي والله ما فهمت كلام قبل. قلت له يا مولانا كيف تدعو ضدنا؟ قلت له هل أنت ذهبت لبريطانيا ودعيت للإسلام, وصلت له رسالة الإسلام الحقيقية بالرحمة واللين؟ قال لي لا. قلت له نحن سادين ثغرة عنك, إذا دعيت ضدهم دعيت ضدنا نحن. فلذلك يجب علينا يا إخواننا لا ندعو ضد الناس, ندعو لهم بالهداية, ندعو لهم بالتقويم الحسن القيم إن شاء الله.
صحيح والله يا شيخ, الرسائل كثيرة والناس بشكروا فيك, وأنا حصلي بحاول بمرر عشان الناس يعني تعرف إن إحنا في يعني الناس كثيرة متابعاك من السودان, دل جمعية البيئة في السودان مهتمين برضو. بارك الله فيك يا شيخ بابكر, سبحانك الله. في من أكسفور متابعينك, ناس الجالية, ناس سمير العجب, يعني متابعينك ناس كثير.
أتمنى إنه
يجزيهم الله خير ويشاركوك أكثر. في بس أنا حاجة دائرة إن هي انتباه كلام, طبعا أنت متابع ناس أخون الجزولي وتكافل, بيعملوا عمل كبير جدا.
الله يجزيهم ألف خير.
وأنت تكلمت الليلة عن نعمة شنو ده من تكافل, فدي ذات فرصة بس نصيحة تنهينينا بها الليلة اللي قال الليلة ده, نحن عشان نتكافل أكثر. ما ناس التكافل جايمين بمجهود كبير جدا في دفن الموتى وترحيلهم, وأنت تتابع شغلهم ده كله طبعا.
نعم نعم.
أخون الجزولي ديل شنو الزيادة اللي ممكن نعمله فرصة زي دي, احنا قاعدين والناس كلها موجودة, يعني نتكافل أكتر كيف؟ أدينا كده
والله يا مولانا
تنهيبات ليلة لغاية الليلة ده.
نعم, أهم شيء في التكافل يا مولانا which is very very important أنه نساعد الناس ديل ماديا, لأنه المادة هي أساس كل شيء. يعني احنا الآن محبوسين في بيوتنا ما نقدر ندي, يعني نطوع بأجسامنا عشان نساعد, لكن ممكن نقدم بالمادة. ومحتاجين نشيل البنك من التلفون عندنا, ممكن نحول الفلوس من حسابنا لحسابهم هنا. والله يا إخواننا رب درهم سبق ألف درهم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال perhaps one درهم will be better in the sight of God than 1,000 درهم. Don't think I don't have a lot of money to give. Give جنيه واحد, one pound will be good by helping them. And the second thing you could do is to contact them and to see what other you can do for them, because they know better than myself. And also pray for them, make dua for them, because they are doing one of the best jobs. Just recently, a friend of ours passed away, and because he had corona, we couldn't get to the graveyard. We had his funeral virtual. I was sitting at home, and then we did a memorial for him, and I have to speak in it. And there were about 10,000 people following it around the world. May Allah bless his soul. All these things are important so that we can help the careful to help the people, so that Allah will help us. Okay? كان الله في عون العبد ما كان العبد في عون أخيه. Allah will always be in the service of the servant, as long as the servant is in the service of his brother or sister. And I would like to remind everybody who is listening now, inshallah, bi-idhnillah ta'ala, with Professor Allam, tomorrow night, on Wednesday night, 6:30, we want to do a special program about the night of mid-Sha'ban. لأن الخميس يوم 15 شعبان. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان بيصوم شعبان كله أو يفطر منه يومين أو ثلاثة في النهاية. أحب الأيام صيام الله بعد رمضان. The most favorite days to fast was in the month of Sha'ban. Why? Because he said, it is my month, Sha'ban and Shahri. So, inshallah, tomorrow night, we're going to do this program. I will talk to you, Dr. Alam, inshallah, after we finish.
Inshallah, inshallah.
At 6:00 in the evening. We talk about, and we prepare ourselves for Ramadan properly as adults, because now we have nothing. We're sitting at home. So, better for us to prepare a zad for the hereafter, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. Inshallah.
والله يا شيخ جزاك الله كل خير وشكرا, وما شاء الله يعني رسائل كثيره جدا ما نقدر نقولها, وبرضه ناس يشيلوا يقول لنا لا لازم يدعي لنا الشيخ يدعي. فانت ادعي لهم بظهر الغيب للجميع ونختم الحلقه دي وجزاك الله كل خير يا شيخ.
امين. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وال سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. يا رب يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والاكرام يا رفيع الدرجات يا ذا العرش يا من لا اله الا انت يا الله، لا اله الا انت يا حي يا قيوم، لا اله الا انت يا سميع الدعاء يا مجيب الدعاء يا قريب لمن دعاه. اتوجه اليك بنبيك المصطفى واله على الصدق والوفاء ان تكن لنا معينا مزعفا. اللهم يا رب اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وطاعتك وحسن عبادتك. او الله all those who are listening. او الله forgive all our sins. او الله erase all our bad deeds. او الله exchange all our bad deeds to good deeds. او الله raise us in the day of judgment with سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. انا لا was drink from الكوثر from his blessed right hand. A drink that we will never be thirsty thereafter, ya Kareem. Oh Allah, allow us to enter with him into the highest level of Jannah. Oh Allah, we ask you for our parents and their parents to Adam alayhi salam. Those who passed away, may you forgive them and raise them to the highest loftiest place in Jannah. Those who are alive, give them, ya Allah, long life with obedience. Oh Allah, those who are sick, heal them. Oh Allah, those who are sick, heal them. Oh Allah, those who are in hospital, remove the disease from them, ya Kareem, and retain them back safely to their families. And those who passed away, may you forgive them. اللهم رب اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وتولنا واهدنا واهد بنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. وصلي وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله ألف خير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.